G'day, Alucard J here. Now, we just need to address this Vector2 offset by giving it a default value. There are some structs that you can't assign default values to in the constructor. Let's just see if we said Vector2.0. What happens in the console? Okay, we get this error here. Must be a constant or default value. So some reason this constructor doesn't recognize the Vector2. So what if we set a new Vector2? Okay. We get the same error. So we need to find a way that we can express a default value for a Vector2 without getting this kind of error. Now, I have done a couple of searches, and there's a couple of solutions. We can use this typecasting here of default, or we can use this kind of, I don't know what the syntax is, it looks like another type of ternary operator, but I don't know what I'm doing. I'll just make it up as I go along. So I think this one seems a little bit more universal. So let's try adding that in. So let's say Vector2, offset equals null, which is strange because the Vector2 can't be a null. So we'll say this offset equals, and now we need to check offset, if it's equal to null, we'll assign it a value. Okay, just like it had in that example there. So that one showed the, there we are. If it's a null, we'll assign it a value. So let's check what the inspector does now. Okay, so Unity is quite happy with using that as a constructor. Let's add it to our other constructor here. And the same thing. And let's look at what happens when we create an instance of the class. Seems to have typecasted the default Vector2 here. Anyway, that's a little bit strange. But again, I don't exactly know what's going on there. I know how to work around it. So now if we create a Perlin module class, we can give it a size, we can give it a frequency, we can give it octaves, and we could call it there. And yeah, Unity's quite happy with that. Or we could give it an offset. Don't know why it's auto-populated that. I was hoping the IntelliSense would come back up again. Let's see what happens here. Okay, it's quite happy if we give it that. Yeah. But we could give it all its optional parameters. Okay, so this is a good thing to keep in mind when you're creating your own constructors for your class. If you want to have an override default, but then you get a weird error saying it has to be whatever it said it was. Nah. What was that error again? Okay, optional parameter offset must have its constant or default value. You ever see that error? You can use this trick here. If we're not applying anything to this, then we'll give it a value of null. But here, when we give it, we check if it's null. If it's null, we assign it a value. So again, like I said, I think color is another one that comes to mind. So color. Must be a constant or default value. But if we set color question mark, color equals null, we see that's totally acceptable. And then if you had a color, color is null. And that's where you would give it its default override value. Okay? Clear as mud. I hope all that made sense. So anyway, we've now got our properties for our class. We've now got our constructors for our class. Next, we need to find a way of using this class so it will give us back our 2D array of fractal noise.